to Tony's garage from sunny Surrey. Not so sunny today, in fact, but yeah, that makes a change.
This is an introduction to my 1991 Ferrari 348 TS, which is now my daily driver after my BMW 330i had a couple of sensors go on it, so I've sold it on. I'll be doing a separate video on the practicality of using a 348 as a daily driver.
So this unfortunately is my third car now that I've dented that in. Luckily the badge fell off a few weeks later on my drive, so I've still got it. It's like £300 to replace. This is where I reversed into a column where I had to get up early for the dentist. And if you look here, you can see the bumpers, it's deeper, pushed in deeper than the other side, so I'm going to have to get that fixed in February, along with that little that dent in the boot. And another bit of damage where I was showing someone how to open the door, and then I mistakenly drove off with my door not being closed, so it swung wide open. So that'll be done in February too. So here's the front of the car, which has your typical kind of stone chips. You can see that, got scrape. And under here you can see scrapes from attacking speed bumps. Especially the first week I got it, I think there was a temporary one there that, won against the car. Here's the semi-illegal number plate. I don't know, shall I play around with the spacing to get it a bit more Enzo-ish? I don't know, we'll see what the police have to say about that. And yeah, the seats are in pretty good condition. I've had to do a little couple of repairs to the seats where there's been nicks. I'll show you a photo to compare, but here there was damage, and on that bolster just over here there was a nick where the roof unfortunately fell down while I was putting it on while it was dark. If you look at the side of the seat, this is where the car was recovered by the RSC, or in fact one of their external suppliers, and I wasn't around to take the car back to the garage, so I didn't see the damage till 7 weeks later when I collected it.
The 348 often gets blasted for its lackluster performance and snap oversteer. The later ones had some tweaks to address this. There's also the Competition version with a sports exhaust and 190 kilos shed and weight. This version in fact had similar performance to the 355, making it like the ultimate of these last analog Ferraris, where the driver aid started taking over. These are the true last go-karts, so to speak. Unfortunately, only 50 examples of the Competition version were ever produced. Also, this purebred wasn't available in Targa or Spider, so no good for us lucky ones in the warmer climates. Me being not one of those purists that never tinker with them, my main aim is to get that kind of visceral experience with the highest flow exhaust on the market by Fab Speed, with also a decap and forged manifold. This combined with an ECU remap and some weight saving should get me there, that kind of real performance that matches the exotic looks of the car. It helps that the 348 isn't one of those ultra expensive Ferraris that forbid you from really actually using it. Now it's time for me to shut up and let the car do the talking. How do you find the clutch then?
Good. Hard as f***.
Slow down.
It is hard. Woo. Go to my cash guy.
Me nervous?
Never.
Yeah, the first owner of this car was a woman, so women drivers are just as good as men.
Really? I think it's better.
Could be.
That's quite smooth to be fair. My first attempt was only 10 seconds, so I didn't have a chance to. Yeah.
How does the throttle compared to your cash car then?
My cash car is obviously better, but you know, I'm grading to a Ferrari, so it's